One, we have to talk about the main pièce de résistance and the person who's on the flyer of my or flyer, sorry, the thumbnail of the flipping No Random show today. It is Doknow. Doknow has committed one of the biggest bag fumbles I've ever seen in real time, and for some reason, it's really bothered me. It's bothered me more so because it's just kind of. Is a another bit of confirmation that these content creators, these people on the various platforms who have been kind of touched by the gods of flipping making a living, they've been touched by the gods of flipping success and fandom and notoriety and virality, are just taking their positions and their blessings for granted. That's the thing. And most of the time, it's usually stuff that it's just so avoidable and so unnecessary. In the case of Doknow, one half or, you know, one third of the flipping Brown Bag podcast, he was part of a really fun collective called Brown Bag. Brown Bag was this, you know, Hispanic, Latino, Mexican, whatever you want to call it, based podcast, which there's not a lot of within that kind of hip hop space, representing for the West Coast, doing some great things, putting people on, having fun, talking about their cultural things that they talk about, and just being a vibe, right? Great show and the premise of it. You think about it. There's a whole slew of people from that part of the world when it comes to Central America, North America, Central America, South America and stuff, Hispanics, you know, Spanish speaking countries for the most part. Many of them who are basically imbued within the hip hop community and industry there in LA. So when the Brown Bag podcast came around and said doing what they were doing, I'm sure it was doing bits and successful just off that malarkey because it served a niche and they focused on it and they killed it. Then along the way, Power 106, one of the biggest radio stations out there in LA, decides, hey, we like what you're doing. We see what you're doing. We want to bring you on board. We want you to bring your show that you're doing in your studio onto our syndicated broadcasting radio station thing that we do here. You do this in the mornings, you get a nice paycheck, and you can continue doing your podcast on the side if you want to. But this will be your main thing. And you'll be in the ears and the cars and the, you know, attention of all these thousands or maybe millions of people around the world. Or sometimes, you know, mainly in North America and stuff. So a great opportunity for you to kind of broaden your horizons. And guess what Doknow does? He fucks it up, of course. How's he fucking up? He decides to make a really tasteless joke about Oscar De La Hoya and his alleged battles with the old cocaina just after they interviewed him. Just after the interview, he makes a joke about Oscar De La Hoya doing cocaine. And of course, that led, I reckon, to him being fired. I don't think it was the main reason. I think it led to him being fired. And, you know, the following shows, he wasn't on the Brown Bag podcast. People were hypothesizing and theorizing and whatever it may be on social. And then he finally spoke out and broke his silence after the whole fact and said the following via this screenshot. I am no longer at Power 106 LA. I couldn't name three rap albums from the 90s and I had way too many corridos on my playlist. LOL, joking. I decided to part ways and it just wasn't for me. Shout out to them for the opportunity. Forever grateful. And make sure you listen to Letty and at Rosen Stars Vic, however you say his name, sorry, every morning. And the following tweet, and it's still Brown Bag Podcast. We're just working on things. Clearly for me, this is a firing. I don't think it's only the Oscar De La Hoya thing. I get the feeling that most likely Doknow just couldn't wake up early in the morning because I've, you know, from various accounts, especially listening to like early episodes of like The Breakfast Club with Charlamagne Tha God and DJ Envy and stuff and Angela Yee. The one thing I remember they used to always complain about and say that it got some adjusting to, your dad adjust to, it took some adjusting to, but sorry, was waking up early in the morning. That was one thing that kind of was very difficult when you're doing morning radio because you'd imagine doing morning radio, you have to probably leave wherever you're living at 3 a.m. in the morning, maybe earlier, to get to the station before 6 or whenever the flipping early morning shift starts. So it's a bit of a hard slog to do Monday to Friday. It's not the easiest thing, especially if you're a young dude like, you know, Doknow and you're only 21, you're only 22, you're only 23, however old he is. To suddenly go from living your you know, crazy hedonistic bachelor, chill young man life, living at home, eating when you want, drinking when you want, staying up late as possible and having to clock in at a normal job is difficult. But just imagine all of the benefits that come from it. You're on Power 106, the biggest radio station on there. You've also got the podcast on the side. Most likely working at that radio station is going to open doors for you that you could have never opened on your own. You're going to be in the industry. You're going to have connections. You're going to build relationships with people. Whatever, it's going to open avenues, like, you know, walk through business over there in the West Coast is big, where you go to a fucking club and you essentially walk through. You sit at a table, they give you free drinks, and at the end of the night, the flipping promoter pays you money because they hope that because you're famous, they can put you on a flyer, more people are going to come, they're going to buy more tables. So you get paid to club, and they even sometimes give you drinks for free. And off the back of that, you can do other things, hosting, whatever it may be, all from that radio gig. So it's kind of like, you know, it's going to kill your social life for a bit. It might kill your back. It might kill your sleep pattern. It's going to take it out. It's going to be difficult. But the benefits far outweigh the negatives. And he couldn't do it just for a year. Just bang it out for a year. Maybe even 6 months. Couldn't do it. Immediately got himself fired. Such a big, big, big bag fumble. Because you'd imagine that's like a guaranteed check that you're getting every month from a radio station, on top of whatever else you're doing. Content on your own channel, content on your own flipping social media platforms, you know, jumping on other podcasts, he's on that Figmunity world, all these other things you're doing, it's only adding to it. So imagine what you're clearing on a monthly basis. I'd hate to look. Let's see. Morning host, Power 106 LA salary. I don't think it's going to come up, but let's see what a roughly salary is. Right? An on-air personality on Power 106 gets between 40,000 to 60,000 per year. Now, don't get me wrong. Living in LA, I'm sure this isn't the greatest salary. But just imagine, we're talking about Doknow here, who's a pretty big and successful social media content creator on his own right. Right? He's young, he's still new in this, but he's got a decent following. He's got a decent, you know, subscriber base on his YouTube. He does decent views. He's on the number of shows. He could easily be, if you know, not pocket watching again, he could easily be making or clearing upwards of 10,000 a month, maybe even to the hundreds of thousands if he plays his cards right. Just because of the little extra bit that you get from fucking working a job. And this is not just any job. This is a job in the industry, in media, in entertainment that could lead to other things. TV, movies, books, whatever. This could open doors to. And he still managed to fuck it up. That's why I think this might be one of the biggest bag fumbles we've ever seen of all time. Legit. And I'm curious to see what people say under the tweet, actually. Let's go over it. Let's see what people said under the tweet itself. First person. Homie didn't want to wake up early. Agreed. Another person. My guy got fired for calling De La Hera a cokehead. Another one. Oscar De La Coca didn't like that caption. Another one. Partying gets old, bro. Don't let that get in the way of your legacy. Which is really accurate. But that's also something I've kind of spoken about. And I think I mentioned it on my Patreon. So make sure you check out my Patreon. Patreon.com/AgostinhoZinga. Recent episode where I spoke a little bit about the Chris Brown and Usher thing. And basically my whole takeaway from that was that, why is it that it's looked down upon to be a fuck up and to kind of do this and party instead of caring about your legacy? Why is that such a bad thing? Why can't some people legitimately choose, like an adult, and say, you know what, I'd rather party and get the itches than actually focus on the work and my career, my legacy? That should be allowed. You should be allowed to self-sabotage. You should be allowed to bag fumble in peace without people like myself criticizing you. I think so. It's weird to say this, but there should be an avenue where if you're old enough to make a decision where you say, you know what, I'm not going to turn up to work, you should be old enough to accept the consequences of it. And sometimes it's not, you know, because there's all this saying, people say, oh yeah, you'll learn from your mistakes, you'll get better from this. Maybe you won't. Maybe you won't. Maybe this is your destiny. Maybe your destiny is to be the bag fumbler until the end of time. That's okay. At least you have a good story to tell when you're at a bar or at some barbecue somewhere. That's okay. Yeah. That's perfectly fine. Anyway, it continues. Another person said, see, look, this is even something I didn't even think about. Big up Santiago Munoz. Influencer money runs out. you threw away a career by losing Power 106. I didn't even think about that. I didn't even think about the fact that being an influencer and trying to create content in that regard and getting paid that way is actually hard to do and to sustain long term. Maybe having a actual legit radio career, an actual legit CV that you can kind of show, might be a good thing for the long term if you decide to pivot. Or like as a fallback plan. If you, you know, if your clout starts to disappear and people don't stop caring about you. Wow, I never even thought about that. This meme is amazing. How the fuck you get fired on your day off? Another person says, please don't let it be that you couldn't wake up early. Imagine if that's the, and a part of me as well thinks that largely, because I've seen a lot of people online, right? Because again, it just frustrates me, because I guess because me making content and working a regular job, I know what I'd rather do, right? But I think in general, I think most of these guys and girls who struggle to kind of, you know, just be grateful for what they have, work hard at it, have fun and kind of keep it moving, and they're always involved in drama. I reckon, or I wonder, thinking aloud, if this has anything to do with a lot of these people being quite lucky in life where they hadn't really had to work regular jobs for the most part. They were able to kind of always get by doing kind of fun stuff, entertainment stuff, content stuff, that they've had to just work like stacking shelves somewhere. Like, not in, like, I think everyone does it when you're a kid, but actually doing that when you're an adult, like doing that in your late 20s, like you're actually working in a shop, you're actually working in a bar, you're a fucking bar back, you're doing stock work and shit. Like, I think some of these guys haven't done that. So I think because of that, you take that stuff for granted. And you think the content shit is like forever, it's evergreen. And you don't ever kind of, you know, look back and think, hey, this is a blessing. I should maybe take this seriously and really kind of, you know, make the most of the situation that I've got at the moment. Because there are some people like my, you know, who like, you know, I remember there was a time once where I was working in this place. I was working in this art supplies company. Right. And I think at the time I moved to my place, I think at the time, wherever place I was living at, the rent must have been like £500 a month, right? £500 a month. And I was working in this place in the west of London, and I live in the east, right? So it's west. And I legitimately, at the end of the month, was getting paid, at the end of the month, after all taxes and shit, I was getting like £989, not even £1,000. And my rent was £500. And then I had to pay my bills, just my rent alone. So I was left with like £423. God forbid on that month, if I had an overdraft, I'll be left with like 300 and something. There was that kind of month where I'll be basically trying to stretch 100 quid for like 4 weeks. Right? Back in the day. So when you kind of come from that sort of life, it's very difficult to get, like, to feel sympathy for these guys when they fuck up such easy bags. It's very difficult. It's very difficult to have sympathy with, because this is nothing. You have to wake up like early. What to sit? And it's not waking up early to go work in a building site or waking up early to go set tables. You're waking up early to go and sit in front of a microphone and laugh and joke around with some of your best friends and talk about topics that you know about intrinsically, like you are an expert in, where it comes to gossiping about celebrities or talking about music and shit. It's not like they're asking you about, you know, about fucking Fermi's paradox or some shit, you know? You're talking about stuff in your field of expertise and you still fuck it up. That for me is like mind-boggling. Mind-boggling. Another one person says, dude, you couldn't wake up early. Only reason why I listen to the stations. Everybody's killing you for the waking up stuff. So I guess this is a common theme. Because my theory is that Doknow most likely was turning up late a lot. Obviously, on air, if you've heard him on podcasts, you would know Duno's in a quiet taste. He's kind of annoying. He's definitely in a single digit IQ and culturally not the smartest guy. Doesn't really have the most interesting takes. So all of that combined, then you're making jokes about Oscar De La Hoya and coke and shit after you just interviewed him, super unprofessional. Then they said get out. So they're probably looking for any excuse to get him out. Then he obviously gave him an excuse on a fucking silver platter. Another person, how do you get fired on your day off? Another one, no more no jumper, now no more Power 106. I guess when you lost clout chasing, you be hopping around. And that's a big takeaway from it. He left no jumper to do his own thing. Figmunity World is doing their thing, but it's still growing. Then you get signed to power 106. You think you've kind of, you know, shown that, hey, I can do it on my own, and then you get fired. Fuck me. It was those Oscar De La Hoya comments, huh? Another one, see? Just fumbling the bag. How you get fired on your day of meme again. Running away from the grind. SMH, you can't be... Running away from the grind is hilarious, isn't it? Running away from hard work. Nice way to saying you got fired on your day off. Fumble the bag 101. Definitely noticed you were missing, but I hope it means that you'll be getting more videos. Still waiting for that second ASMR video. I think this person wants to fuck. Another one. Homegirl domestic. But why? You made the first 2 hours of my clocking into work go by fast. Gonna miss hearing you on the radio. So again, forget just you. He had actual fans like this person who looked forward to hearing him on the radio every single day before work. And guess what? He fumbled it and now has in part ruined her morning commute, ruined her morning work, or whoever this person is. Jesus Christ, do know, man. Absolutely horrific. But yeah, biggest bag fumble I've ever seen, to be honest. And I have no sympathy. It is what it is. He hopefully lands on his feet. Maybe he doesn't. It goes back to my whole adage. You should be allowed to be a fuck up. If he's a fuck up, let him be a fuck up. It's all good. You know, he'll figure it out. Or he won't. But we will watch and laugh. We will watch and laugh. Or I will, at least, anyway. Anyway.